So I think all the ladies are jealous of me right now because I'm with Louis Tan. And I'm kind of like trying to stand on my tippy toes because can he's you, like, he
is this in
he's
frame?
Like, he's like way, he's definitely as tall as he seems. Which a lot of actors aren't like that.
Yes, that's right. They stand on apple boxes and use the camera really low to get that super angle, superhero angle.
Yeah, but you don't have to do that.
I don't.
Which is great.
I do this.
So tell me, this is your first Comic-Con. How's it going so far?
I'm overwhelmed. I can't like look in one direction. There's just so much going on. But I was told that I was going to have to deal with this, so you know.
Yeah.
It is everything that they say and more.
Tell me about what projects you're working on right now.
Yeah, I just wrapped a movie with Gerard Butler and Curtis Jackson called Den of Thieves. It's like a crime heist bank robber thriller. And that comes out January 19th, I believe. So.
And what's your role?
Well, this time I get to play one of the good guys. So.
Really? Okay, how does it feel to be one of the good guys?
It's cool, it's like a whole new world, you know? But I mean, I enjoy playing bad guys. It's fun, I like being the bad guy. I don't mind it.
Why is it fun to be the bad guy?
I mean, you get to kill more people usually and get to have really interesting character quirks. And at first I was fighting against it, like, man, I want to play the hero, but I miss playing the bad guy, actually.
You get to kill more people?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fun, right? What about any other projects? Are there any other little secret projects you have going on?
Yeah, there's a, yeah, I'm filming something right now that's not yet announced, but in the next month or so, you'll hear about it. And it's one of the biggest films of next year, so I'm very, very excited.
Wow, sure you can't tell us? We won't tell anybody.
Not gonna happen.
While you're out here, you're doing a couple of panels, so tell me a little bit about that.
There's a panel today, tomorrow. I think the Super Asian American panel is something that's really important to me, and I'm really looking forward to that.
How does it feel to be an Asian American that's working on big films now? What does that mean to you?
It feels amazing. I mean, my father's been in the business for a long time, so this is something that is not new to me. I've grown up on movie sets since I was 2 years old. And there was always this thing inside of me where I wanted to kind of take it from there and take it to the next level.
What's some advice that your dad gave you when coming into the business?
Not to be offended. Be nice to everyone, including, you know, every single person on set. The actors that I respect the most are people that treat everybody the way that they want to be treated, and I think it's really important to be that way at this level and at a high level.
I noticed you have a tattoo on your back right here.
She's talking about this
one. You can see it, this one. Yeah. So tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, this tattoo has been featured in a lot of different shows, by the way, too. Like, they never cover it, so it was cool. It was an iron fist and everything.
Yeah, it's a cool tattoo.
It means servant in Chinese. And it's just a kind of like a spiritual tattoo and a reminder to serve a higher purpose. And I also have king on my arm. So it's that dichotomy of having the confidence, but also being able to serve others and help others.
You know, it's kind of related to what you were talking about. So it's really good to have, you know, Asian Americans out there and also have somebody that's humble.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here representing for the Asian American community, and there's much more to come, and I'm not stopping. So this is something that's we're gonna break down the wall, and it's coming down. So I'm glad to be a part of it.
Tell me a little bit about Iron Fist and your experience there.
It was crazy. I mean, we shot in New York City. I was staying in Brooklyn. It was super surreal. I mean, some of my favorite movies were shot in New York, and I've never filmed there. So I've been there before, but I never had filmed there. So it was really a nostalgic experience for me to be filming in New York. I went through a vigorous training session to learn how to do drunken kung fu, which I had no idea how to do. They called me and they're like, do you know drunken kung fu? Because they know I do martial arts.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I've been drunk and been in street fights. Does that count? And they're like, nope. Get your ass in New York. We're going to train. It was a lot of physical hard work. Then also I'm doing an accent from Northern England, which I could do an accent really easily. Like, it's no problem, yeah? But like, it's not really Northern England. It's more London. So it's more Cockney, yeah?
Well, I mean, I'm convinced by your accent.
I had a lot of fans. You know, I got so much critical acclaim from fans and people sending me love that it was super gratifying when it came out. So it was a lot of work, but it was definitely worth it.
I hope you enjoy the rest of your Comic-Con.
Thank
you. It was a pleasure to talk to you, and I'm going to keep up on your secret.
I'm super excited to be here. There's a lot coming, guys, so be on the lookout for it and check out Den of Thieves January 19th. Thanks for having me. What's up? This is Louis Tan, and you're watching Mix TV.